Please stand to pray the Angelus. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done to me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Prayer to Saint Michael. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Oratio imperata. Merciful and compassionate Father, we confess our sins, and we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 virus that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love, and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide a people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Bless our efforts to use the medicines developed to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers, that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this, your Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Saint James the Great,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated for a while. Our Mass will begin shortly. Good morning. Welcome to the celebration of the Holy Eucharist this first Saturday, the Feast of the Transfiguration. Let us all please stand and welcome our presiding priest, Father Angel Sanchez.
Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate today the Feast of the Transfiguration of our Lord, may we continue to be renewed by the gift of faith that the Lord bestows on us. May we always remain in His love and be renewed through reconciliation, compassion, and mercy. And for the many times we have not been able to totally conform ourselves to the heart of our Lord Jesus, we beg for His pardon and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son confirmed the mysteries of faith by the witness of the fathers and wonderfully prefigured our full adoption to sonship, grant, we pray, to your servants that listening to the voice of your beloved Son, we may merit to become co-heirs with him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As I watched, thrones were set up, and the Ancient One took his throne. His clothing was bright as snow, and the hair on his head as white as wool. His throne was flames of fire and wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of fire flowed out from where he sat. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads attended him. The court was convened, and the books were opened. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
The Lord is King, let the earth rejoice. Let the many islands be glad. Clouds and darkness are round about him. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his justice, and all people see his glory.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
Because you, O Lord, are the Most High over all the earth, exalted far above all gods.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, we did not follow cleverly devised myths when we made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But we have been eyewitnesses of his majesty, for he received honor and glory from God the Father when that unique declaration came to him from the majestic glory. This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven while we were with him on the holy mountain. Moreover, we possess the prophetic message that is altogether reliable. You will do well to be attentive to it, as to a lamp shining in a dark place, until day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us all please stand to honor the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia, this is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus took Peter, John, and James and went up a mountain to pray. While he was praying, his face changed in appearance, and his clothing became dazzling white. And behold, two men were conversing with him, Moses and Elijah, who appeared in glory and spoke of his exodus that he was going to accomplish in Jerusalem. Peter and his companions had been overcome by sleep, but becoming fully awake, they saw his glory and the two men standing with him. As they were about to part from him, Peter said to Jesus, "Master, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." But he did not know what he was saying. While he was still speaking, a cloud came and cast a shadow over them, and they became frightened when they entered the cloud. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, "This is my chosen son. Listen to him." After the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone. They fell silent and did not at that time tell anyone what they had seen. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There was once this elderly woman, frail in health, and she was speaking with her doctor and expressing her hope that she would have the strength to live just a few more months so that she could celebrate the birth of her first grandchild. Sure enough, the day came and the woman was present and well enough to hold the little child in her arms. When the woman went back to her doctor, he suggested that it would be important to set a new goal so that she had something to look forward to, something to keep her going. Then the elderly woman said to the doctor, "Well, my son did just buy me a new refrigerator, and it is guaranteed for 10 years. My dear friends, in our gospel for today, we hear about the account of Luke on the transfiguration of our Lord Jesus. And why did the Lord reveal his glory to the disciples in this way? St. Thomas Aquinas teaches us that this grace was given to strengthen the disciples for the forthcoming scandal of the cross by giving them a glimpse of the glorious resurrection. St. Thomas Aquinas said, "For a person to go straight along the road, he must have some knowledge of the end, just as an archer will not shoot an arrow straight unless he first sees the target. This is particularly necessary if the road is hard and rough, the going heavy, and the end delightful." How often do we get afraid and discouraged? How many times did we ask, "Where is the Lord in all of these things?" When we undergo personal and family crises, such as terminal illness, breakdown of relationships between husband and wife, between parent and child, between friends. When we see so many atrocities in life, both here and abroad. When we see good people suffering while the evil ones go unpunished. At times like this, we need to go up the mountain of prayer and ask God to open our eyes that we may see. In prayer, God grants us a glimpse of eternity. Then we shall realize that all our troubles in this life are short-lived. Then shall we have the courage to accept the apparently meaninglessness suffering of this life, knowing that through it all, God is on our side. In prayer, we can rest at times, just be glad, happy and content to be with the Lord in His presence and in His love. The transfiguration was for the benefit of the disciples, for their faith and confidence in the lasting glory of Jesus even at the most difficult times. It can be so each time that we pray to the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, the Transfiguration of Jesus is always for us a message of hope and encouragement. This experience is not only limited to the disciples who personally witnessed it, but it is an experience that we can witness to whenever we are in prayer and whenever we are part of the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. May we never lose sight of God's promise of eternal life. Amen.
Please stand.
In the Transfiguration, the Father revealed the glory of His Son. We do not see His glory now, but as we wait for the kingdom, we pray in His name to the Father. Let Your power and glory shine on us, Lord.
Let Your power and glory shine on us, Lord.
That the glory of Christ may shine through the Church as we faithfully listen to Him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let Your power and glory shine on us, Lord.
That the beloved Son may lead the nations into the paths of peace and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let Your power and glory shine on us, Lord.
That we may grow in grace, that others may see the light of Jesus in our lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let Your power and glory shine on us, Lord.
That people who suffer may see their future in the transfigured Redeemer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let Your power and glory shine on us, Lord.
That the dead may be transfigured in the likeness of Christ's glorious body. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let Your power and glory shine on us, Lord.
In silence, let us pray for our personal intentions, the Mass intentions for today, and those that have asked us to pray for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let Your power and glory shine on us, Lord.
Lord God, it is wonderful for us to be here. Receive the prayers of this community, assembled to hear Your words and to offer the sacrifice of Your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Take what we bring now and
stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Sanctify, O Lord, we pray, these offerings here made to celebrate the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son, and by his radiant splendor, cleanse us from the stains of sin, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he revealed his glory in the presence of chosen witnesses, and filled with the greatest splendor that bodily form which he shares with all humanity, that the scandal of the cross might be removed from the hearts of his disciples, and that he might show how in the body of the whole church is to be fulfilled what so wonderfully shone forth first in its head. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jesse, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
but I am not worthy, that you should enter under my roof.
But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
You shall wander far in safety.
Stand for the prayer after communion.
Let us pray. May the heavenly nourishment we have received, O Lord, we pray, transform us into the likeness of your Son, whose radiant splendor you willed to make manifest in his glorious transfiguration, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Prayer to Our Lady of Fatima. All together, please. Hail, Mother of the Lord, Virgin Mary, Queen of the Rosary of Fatima. Blessed among all women, you are the image of the Church dressed in the Paschal light. You are the honor of our people. You are the triumph over the mark of evil. Prophesy of the merciful love of the Lord. Teacher of the Annunciation of the good news of the Son. Sign of the burning fire of the Holy Spirit, teach us in this valley of joys and sorrows the eternal truths that the Father reveals to the little ones. Show us the strength of your mantle of protection. In your Immaculate Heart, be the refuge of sinners and the way that leads to God. In the unity with our brothers and sisters, in faith, hope, and love, we surrender ourselves to you. In unity with all our brothers and sisters, through you we consecrate ourselves to God. O Virgin of the Rosary of Fatima, and thus surrounded by the light that comes from your hands, we will give glory to the Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Dear